From Din Djarin's return to Mandalore to Grogu finally embracing his Force abilities, The Mandalorian Season 3 is shaping up to be a real home run for the Star Wars franchise. So let's talk about everything we know so far, starting with the return to Mandalore. I mean, this is it, right? The culmination of everything that the show's been inching toward for the past couple of seasons. The Mandalorian tribes are at an impasse, and there seems to be a rising threat in the form of the First Order. This is the time when the people of Mandalore need a ruler to unite them. But that's where things get a little more complicated. After all, even though Din has the Darksaber right now, which technically makes him the rightful ruler, he doesn't actually want to do any of that. Instead, the reason for his return is a lot more personal. Cause yep, he wants to atone for his sin. And by sin, I mean removing his helmet and getting kicked from the Children of the Watch. Now, judging from what the trailers have shown, it seems like Mando's gonna venture deep into the living waters beneath the mines of Mandalore.
I've spent much time on Tatooine. I've never seen a Mandalorian there.
My information is good, I tell you. The city of Mos Pelgo. I swear it by the Gotra.
Tatooine it is, then.
Wait!
And there's a good chance he could eventually become the leader of his tribe, too. After all, the trailer does sorta allude to other Mandalorians following his orders. But, of course, amidst this quest for atonement and the fight for the throne, there's one question that people forget. Is there anything even left on Mandalore?
This is no place for a child. Wherever I go, he goes. So I've heard. Requested to bring him to his kind. If I can locate other Mandalorians, they can help guide me. I'm told you know where to find them.
Like, wasn't this the big quote-unquote conundrum in Season 2? Din has been told by his tribe that Mandalore was nothing but a dangerous wasteland. Well, Boba Fett thought its surface had been turned into ice by the Empire. Bo-Katan Kreese, however, genuinely believes that she can go back to the planet and rule it. With that said, she's obviously got to have the Darksaber on her to actually back up her claims of being the rightful heir to the throne. Now, this is another big issue that Season 3 will address. Bo-Katan cannot just accept the Darksaber from Din, and instead, she's gotta beat him in a 1v1 battle. But remember, Mando doesn't actually want to fight her. So you see the problem, right? Though one shot in the trailer shows that she's already sitting on the throne. Now, whether she's waiting for Mando to arrive or has already defeated him, we'll just have to wait and find out. Oh, and it's also perhaps worth noting that Moff Gideon is also alive, apparently, meaning he could throw a spanner in the works and be the big bad guy again. You know who else could shake things up on Mandalore? Grogu. Yep, the little green boy is back, and this time, he actually seems to be in control of his Force abilities. Wait a sec though, didn't he leave with Luke Skywalker at the end of Season 2? To be a Jedi and all that. How is he back all of a sudden? Well, this is perhaps where Disney made a mistake, because they went ahead and added an entire Grogu arc in the Book of Boba Fett. So, in case you missed it, essentially, Grogu refuses to train with Luke and chooses to return to Din again. And now, he's being trained to embrace the ways of a Mandalorian. But, of course, while the focus will be on the situation on Mandalore in Season 3, I'm sure Grogu will get some time to shine as well. As a matter of fact, it wouldn't be surprising if the show goes hard on the whole side plot with him and the cloning experiments. Not to mention, even the trailer shows a shot of the Jedi Temple during Order 66. So my guess is that we're gonna see who saved the little dude at that time and what exactly happened to him. And obviously, this could also open up a whole other can of worms. After all, the experiments on Grogu are linked to Palpatine's return. Yep, this could honestly be the big reveal in Season 3, because judging by everything that Moff Gideon revealed about this Force-sensitive cloning.
Where is this going?
This is where it's going. I'm guessing that Bo-Katan and her boarding party have arrived at the bridge, seeking me, or more accurately, this.
it all points toward a resurrection for the Emperor. And I mean, it'd make perfect sense in terms of the timeline as well. The First Order is on the rise, and Luke is establishing a Jedi Academy, which of course means Ben Solo training under him as well. Not to mention, Snoke, who was another Palpatine clone, has to rise sooner rather than later too. After all, he's the one who turns Ben into Kylo Ren. Like, you see where I'm going with this, right? So these dominoes have to start falling at some point as well. And most fans would agree that The Mandalorian can be a pretty good show to expand on this timeline between the OG and sequel trilogies. The puzzle pieces are falling into place perfectly. And honestly, season 3 could end up being one of the most important pieces of modern Star Wars media. But hey, no pressure. With the story details out of the way though, I guess it's time to talk about the actual production stuff, which of course starts with the cast. Now, The Mandalorian has had a pretty small cast over the past couple of seasons. Like, for the most part, it's just Pedro Pascal donning the helmet and adventuring with his little puppet friend. Though, of course, other characters have been confirmed for season 3 as well. Giancarlo Esposito, for example, revealed a few months ago that he's going to return, once again, to play the role of Moff Gideon. Not to mention, Katie Sackhoff will also come back as Bo-Katan. Other returning members include Carl Weathers as Karga, Omid Abtahi as Dr. Pershing, and Amy Sedaris as Peli Motto. Oh, and let's not forget Emily Swallow's Armorer and Sun Hyung Lee's Carson Teva either. As for the new characters, we know Christopher Lloyd and Tim Meadows are joining the series for season 3, though we don't know what roles they're going to play. Oh, and here's a spicy rumor for you. We might even see Hayden Christensen as Anakin Skywalker in one of the Order 66 flashback scenes. With that said, it's now time to answer the most important question of them all. When is The Mandalorian season 3 coming out? And thankfully, it's all good news, cause the show is slated to premiere on Disney Plus from March 1st. Jon Favreau will once again take the reins for the overall production, writing, and just about everything. But of course, he's got his best bud and resident Star Wars nerd Dave Filoni alongside to help him as well. After all, he's almost done with the production of the Ahsoka show. In fact, Filoni and Nora Kluwer have written some of the episodes this season too. As for the directors, well, things are more or less the same in that department too, which means that obviously, Carl Weathers and Bryce Dallas Howard are going to return to share the load between them. Though interestingly, Rick Famuyiwa is gonna have a director seat as well. Oh, and above all of them is Kathleen Kennedy, who remains at her executive producer post. Phew, that's a lot of people. And honestly, with a show that's as important and big as The Mandalorian, it makes perfect sense. I mean, after the mixed reviews that The Book of Boba Fett got, this show cannot afford to be mediocre. That said, I don't know about you, but I've got full faith in it. Like, they've already proven that they know what it takes to make a good Mandalorian story. Plus, with everything we've seen in the trailers, it's all pointing toward an incredible conclusion as well. So, fingers crossed. And that, folks, was everything we know about The Mandalorian Season 3 so far.
Now, it belongs to her.